Church.
Happy Sunday. Welcome to MCC San Diego. It's our mission to bring people closer to God and one another, so we hope that's part of your worship experience with us today. My name is Reverend Caedmon Grace. I'm the Minister of Congregational Life, and our Senior Pastor Dan Cashel is currently in Wisconsin with his family celebrating his nephew's wedding, and he'll be back this week. So we look forward to having him back in the office. If you can, go ahead and reach into the seat back pocket in front of you and take out a Keeping in Touch card. It's one way for you to let us know that you've been here. If you have any prayer requests or praise reports, we'd love to hear that as well and join in prayer. So at this time, let's go ahead and have some announcements for the community.
Okay, that sounds like a great plan, Pastor Caedmon. Good morning, everyone. And it seems that something is going on here at the Met all the time, virtually every weekend. Now, this coming Friday night, it's our monthly community game night at 7 p.m. In the social hall. Come on down for some fun with some really fun people playing Mexican Train or other board games this Friday evening. And then Saturday, it's AIDS Walk San Diego. And Pastor Dan and the Ben Dixon family and I and others will be out bright and early raising funds for the center's HIV and AIDS programs and services. You can still join our team and contribute to any of us in the walk. Team Captain David Ben Dixon will be here after this service. He'll be in the social hall to sign you up or to log you in to support our team. Top fundraiser, Dolly Ben Dixon, she doesn't know this yet, but I have word from a congregant that a check for $1,000 is on its way for Dolly in the AIDS walk. And I know she's going to be thrilled about that when she learns about it, which brings us, I think, close to about $300 short of our goal of $2,500. So we appreciate your help. Now at 4 p.m. this Saturday, the Met is partnering with other community groups to present an arts and transgender diverse community forum at the Diversionary Theater. It includes a reception and a panel discussion. They're going to have readings from some of their gender diverse plays that are coming up this season at the Diversionary. And the event is free, and it's at the Diversionary Theater on Park Boulevard. And Saturday, October 5th, it's our most fun fundraiser of the year, the 8th annual Met Bowl-a-thon at Kearney Mesa Bowl at 10 a.m. $25 gets you 3 games of bowling, shoe rental, food, snacks, a chance at prizes, and a great time to just hang out with some really fun people. Just see Ron Sperry. And you'll have tickets for the bowl-a-thon in the social hall right after service this morning. In 2 weeks from today, on October 6th, it's Pets Day at the Met. We're once again going to pause with a special video to remember our pets who have passed on. If your pet was not included last year, just submit a photo, preferably a JPEG, to me in the church office along with your pet's name and year of birth and passing, and we'll be glad to include your pet in that. And then at 4 p.m. that Sunday, it's our annual blessing of the animals, bringing your pet down to Balboa Park for that blessing, and I'll give you a little certificate of blessing for each pet. And would you believe that 3 weeks from today, on October 13th, it will mark 10 years that we've been in this building here on Denver Street, anniversary of our first service. So that calls for a celebration. So David Root and Danny Hartwood, Bob and Monson are organizing a church picnic on that Sunday. It'll be at 1:30. Pizza will be provided. We invite you to bring side dishes to share. We'll be sharing more about the exact location, but it'll be close by church here right on Mission Bay. And on the floral arrangement, the beautiful one that you see in front of the altar this morning is provided by Pat Coffee and Sandy Goddard. It's on honor of their 30th celebration of their 35 years together and 11 years of legal marriage here in California. Thank you, Pat and Sandy. And that's a great way to end announcements this morning.
All right. Please rise as you're able to greet one another.
To the water, all you who are weary. Come rest in the quiet pools of God's love. We wait upon you, O God, and our strength is restored. God is here among us, washing away the residue of our lives and pouring out the Spirit. You are perfecting the good work began in us, O God. Come to the water, all you who long for justice. Come to be renewed in God's ever-flowing stream. Here we are, source of all life, in sacred union together. Amen.
Thank you. join me in prayer. Loving God, thank you for this beloved community, for the people who welcome us, inspire us, for the people who feed us and keep the doors open. Help us to be open to the people around us in this place and in the places where we work and live. You created the world and every person in it, every tribe, every language, all the people of every nation. We don't always live up to our own ideals. Your ways are not ours. Your thoughts are not our thoughts. Many of us are impatient with the world now. We want an end to gun violence and global warming. We want justice for our trans brothers and sisters, to protect women from men who want to restrict their rights. Some of us are afraid. Some of us are angry. And we want the world to change, to wake up. Show us what we need to do to bring about the changes we want to see in the world, to feel joy and hope. Thank you for the many changes you have brought to our lives, for bringing us into this community of acceptance. We ask you to continue to inspire us, to give us courage, to give us energy, to give us the hope we need to continue to build community and to create change in this world. We ask for all these things and many other things that are on our hearts in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Creator, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Oh, Please rise if you are able. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are the ways my ways, declares God. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and the bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I propose, and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out in joy and be led forth in peace. This is the message of hope.
Praise to you, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit.
Break the yoke and lift your heavy burden.
Jesus is by looking back in the tradition that he came from, the Old Testament, the Jewish tradition. And in Isaiah chapter 55, the prophet is speaking to the people of Israel. And he's speaking to a people who are desperate for something they believe they're worthy of but don't have. Has anybody ever felt like they're worthy of something and they can't get it?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus, yes, okay? So he's speaking to that experience that we have as humans. And the prophet says, come, all you who are thirsty, come to the waters. And you who have no money, come, buy, and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Because why spend money on what is not bread? And why spend your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen to me and eat what is good, and you will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me and listen so that you can have this kind of life. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, the faithful, loving covenant I also promised to David. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, and neither your ways my ways, declare the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways naturally higher than yours, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. So as the rain comes down, this is so good, as the rain and the snow come down from the skies, they do not return to the sky without watering the earth, which makes it bud and flourish, so that there can be seed for the sower to sow and bread for the eater to eat. So it is with my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish what I desire and achieve what I purpose it for. And you will go out with joy and be led forth with peace. This is all about satisfying the thirst, and the only thing you have to have a satisfied thirst is a thirst that needs satisfying. That's it, there are no other requirements. If you're thirsty, here's a drink. Living water, the living water. And then if we jump ahead all the way to the book of Revelation, which is after Jesus and all his teachings, the apostle is on an island, communing with God through prayer and meditation, and has a vision, and says that this, in the end of times, this is the way that it's going to go. And if Jesus was the kind of Jesus who keeps people out and makes them conform to rules before they're worthy, I don't think this future would be the one that was seen. John says, after this, which was a revealing of the 144,000 people who are going to be allowed into heaven, read it, it's great. After this, I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. So in the end of times, the ultimate triumph is for us to be one in God, so much so that language can't divide us, so much so that culture can't divide us, generational differences can't divide us, money differences can't divide us, educational differences, nothing can divide us. Because in God, none of those things matter. Can you imagine worship on a personal level? When you take time to thank God and give praise to God, it encourages your spirit. And all the things that are in your mind concerning you and weighing you down will ever so slightly disappear without you even noticing, because your mind is set on speaking good words of God's faithfulness. And if you do that for yourself, your faith blossoms and you walk through the world in a different way. And then there's another type of worship that's communal, when we all come together. And I've heard it said with metropolitan community churches before, if it weren't for our shared faith in God, and the fact that we all are some form or care about a sexual minority, many of us would never give each other the time of day outside the church. We have such different lives. We believe very different things. And we socialize in different ways. We have different objectives. And regardless of all of that, we can
bring the fullness of who we are as individuals into communal space. And when we're focusing not on who we are, but the common good of all of us and who God is, it unites us in a way that would otherwise create division and tear us apart. And the goal of worship is to come together as one to experience the profound presence of God that heals and transforms and renews us. This is the vision that God has for the church and for the people. And one of the things I want to share with you also is that in the book of Revelation, if the Spirit is saying to John that all people will worship together in spirit and truth at some point, that suggests that we have to believe that all of creation, plants, animals, humans, everything, is subject to the process of redemption. Everything is capable and responsible to be redeemed and live into its fullest, most flourishing self, even us as people. And so if we believe that everybody and everything is capable, God is capable of redeeming them, then that means that we can actually, when we unite in worship, we can accomplish the demolishing of bigger strongholds. We can end systems that oppress people. We can end ways of being that do harm instead of give life. We can end just the need to buy things as if that gives us worth. Consumerism is in contrast with the gospel, because it's about getting things for ourselves instead of providing and creating community together. So my invitation for you this week to practice the effect of worship in every tongue, every language, every tribe, and every nation is to pick two different acts of worship. One of them would be an individual or a personal act of worship. So if, for example, you have never raised your hands for in praise before, maybe put some praise and worship songs on in your home and just stand in front of the mirror and see what it looks like to worship like that for a change. Or if you always lift your hands in worship and you want to try a different type of expression, give it a try and explore another dynamic of God and watch the ways it impacts you. And then choose an act of worship that's communal, so it involves at least one other person, okay? And if that act of worship is just telling your testimony or talking about your prayer life or anything that has to do with why you are who you are in God, share that with another person and watch the way it inspires and transforms and enlivens and creates within others a desire to have that same type of life force welling up within them. And I believe that as we worship together in spirit, as we worship in truth, as we worship in ways that broaden our ideas enough that everybody is welcome, then that's when we truly are able and practicing the genuine worship of God. Because God includes everyone and all things. And if everyone and all things are not present in our worship, someone, something, somewhere is absent. And it's in our best interest for our own souls and our own relationship with God to include as many people as possible in our spiritual journey declaring the word. So I encourage you to worship in spirit, worship in truth, worship with your body in whatever ways you want to practice that. And also, be willing to worship when you don't have any reason to. Because when you feel like hope is gone and things are just too difficult, you can't find a way or anything, if you just start to worship, it shifts the atmosphere. It shifts your thinking. It shifts other people. And things start to move and things start to line up for God's will to be the path that you're on again. Amen?
Amen.
Male, we You can do it via the offering basket that will be coming past you in just a minute. You can do it by credit card. Just see Fred Tyler in our bookstore to register your credit card. You can get the information. It can be done weekly, monthly, however works for you. You can do it by setting it up through your bank or credit union, just like you pay your SBGE or other bills. There's a blue card in the receipt back pocket that explains that procedure. And also, if you do that, and you have probably at least 3 dozen or more people that do that regularly, take one of those blue cards and put that in the offering basket. Recognize it. Your gift that you've already made. Or you can use the text to give procedure just by using your phone and that phone number on the screen. However it comes, just know that it's appreciated, that it's a blessing, and I greatly appreciate it. So that's what we're going to recognize right now as we give to the ministry here at the Met as the ushers come forward to receive our tithes and offerings and what we get.
said, he remembered that thief hanging by his side. Then he spoke of love and compassion. Then he took him to
was to be betrayed, he took bread from the feast, He raised it to heaven, lo levantó. He blessed it, lo bendijo. And he broke it, lo partió. And he gave it to each person present, saying, this is my body that will be broken for you. Take and eat. And as you do, do this in remembrance of me. Hagan esto en memoria mía.
And in a like manner, at the end of the meal, Jesus took the cup, which was filled with the fruit of the vine, and he raised it to heaven, lo levantó, and he blessed it, lo bendijo, and he passed it to those with them, and he said, take this and drink of it, for it is my life essence, which signifies the new and everlasting covenant, offered for many, for grace and forgiveness. Whenever you do this in remembrance of me. Hagan esto en memoria mía.
Would you pray with me, please? Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and fruit of the vine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, as we each understand that to mean. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to the world. Through Jesus Christ and with the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen.
At MCC San Diego and at every MCC around the globe, we celebrate an open communion. And by this we mean that you don't need to be a member of this church or of any church to participate. You can be of any tribe, any tongue, any land, any people, any nation. Yes. You are all welcome to come forward to receive communion. A server will hand you a wafer that has been dipped in juice, and as you serve yourself, that person will say a blessing over you. Afterwards, you may return to your seat and meditate on the blessings of this day. As you ready yourself and follow the directions of the ushers, all we ask is that you come just as you are.
Come.